Subscribe to my channel and hit the bell button so you'll never miss an update.
The number one struggle of every parent with growing kids is to make the kids listen to them. Not just listen, but in many cases also obey what you're saying. But it doesn't happen that way, and many times it results into a power struggle. Most parents I know have some versions of this complaint. Why do I have to keep yelling to get things done? And why can't he do the first time I tell him to? So if you're having this power struggle and have difficulty in finding a way, then keep watching. Because today I'm going to share with you three reasons why your kids don't listen to you and solutions to resolve them. Hey there, I'm Aparna, your personal coach, helping you upskill yourself to lead the life you desire. I have a 13-year-old son, and ever since he's moved into his preteen years, every request from me has hit a roadblock. Until I've understood the reasons behind them and modified my behavior so I can get things done from him. The first reason is that they do not share our priorities. You want them to take a bath, they don't feel the need to. Hence the power struggle. This can be resolved if you understand what their priorities are. What is your child doing when you asked him to take bath? He could be, say, playing a video game. Do you think he'll choose bathing compared to playing video games? Absolutely not. But you can resolve the situation by acknowledging his priority. For example, you may say something like, "Wow, you're already at the fourth level. You're getting really good at this. But it's time to take your bath. So do you want to go right now? Or do you want to go after 5 minutes without having me to remind you? Let's make a deal." 99% of the time, your kid will make a deal with you. Reason number two is that they need our help to change their behavior. What do I mean by that? Remember when you are engrossed completely in your computer screen and are unable to tear yourself away to attend to your child? Kids share similar experience and they get tuned out to our repeated nagging. So they need our help to take them away from, say, the video game. So the solution here is that you go back to him after 5 minutes and say, "The deal's a deal and it's 5 minutes up now, so go take bath." Or you can keep an alarm or a stopwatch which actually counts down to the 5 minutes, so that once the alarm goes, he automatically puts his video on pause and goes to take his bath. There are higher chances that your kid will listen to what you have to say and you can get things done from him this way. Reason number three is that they feel controlled and pushed. This is especially for growing kids who are preteen and beyond, and this is what I've learned at least when dealing with my son. Understand, we cannot make our children obey us. What we really want them to do is to cooperate with us. Know this difference. Kids usually do not push back until and unless they feel that they are not being heard or they feel that they are being controlled. So the solution here is to acknowledge the perspective, and you'll be surprised. Sometimes hearing my son's perspective, I get convinced to change my position, and that's okay. Ensure that your child knows that you've heard them and then offer a choice to them. Staying with the example that I've been giving you, you can say something like, "I know you're saying you don't want to take bath and you'll probably never take bath when you're an adult. But in our house, right now, we have a rule that we do not have breakfast without taking a bath. So you have a choice to either skip the bath and breakfast and risk having the game pulled out from you, or have your bath and breakfast really quick so that you can get back to your game." It's obvious what is the choice that they will make. Children naturally look up to their parents for nurturing and guidance. If we're convinced that we are on their side, they would want to please us. So if you're finding yourself in frequent power struggles, then you may need to work on strengthening your relationship with your child. That's it from me. If you need more information in this regard or help in resolving conflicts with your children, you may reach out to me. All my details are given in the description box below. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you find this video resourceful. Do hit a like button if you do and share it with your friends. And of course, I will see you next week with another topic. Until then, take good care of yourself. Bye.